Thank you. Concert Hall. We hope you enjoy this evening's presentation. At this time, please turn off all cell phones and any other electronic devices that may disturb this evening's performance. Thank you.
Good evening, everybody. We are so happy to be here. We had a really rough January and February, as you might have heard about our virtual mini concert, which is on ISU Bands on Facebook. We are so glad after spring break to come back and be able to present a full concert of really, really amazing music for you. Starting with, of course, Gershwin. I promised a year of really fun music, and that's as fun opener as it gets. Until our second song, which is the American River Songs. American River Songs is a set of about four folk songs, most notably Shenandoah, which you will recognize in the middle. And it's one of the really, really fine arrangements. I've taught it several times. I brought it out to sight read, and I said, okay, let's turn it in. They're like, no, we're gonna play this. I said, okay then, here we go. So I hope you enjoy American River Songs.
Thank you.
See what I mean? So it's been, again, it's been a wonderful thing. As you know, I've been the interim director of bands this year. I'm very excited to hand the baton off, as it is, to our incoming director of bands, Dr. Patrick Young, who hopefully is watching from Georgia, although it's very late at night for him. But he's going to be here in the fall, and we're really excited to work with a new faculty member. And he plays the tuba, and he plays trombone, and he's going to offer a lot for our band kids in the future. So we're really excited for that. Moving on, our next piece is one that I picked. They don't like it as much. It's okay. This one was really hard to sort of wrap our brains around. Imagine a publishing company who goes to Pulitzer Prize level composers and asks them to write middle school band music. It's actually happened. And by us playing it tonight, you know that there was a couple of complications. First of all, this piece by Chen Yi, she is a fantastic, she's a Pulitzer Prize nominated composer. Currently, she was born in China, and she's currently in the University of Missouri, Kansas City. And she was asked to write a middle school band piece. The first thing we had to tackle was she wanted us to use Chinese instruments. So thank you to Tom Hasenflug, who has a bunch of Chinese instruments in his office. We were able to actually give you the experience of a Chinese gong and Chinese cymbals, which we're very excited about. The next thing you're going to notice immediately, this piece is really hard. And so our brass players are putting in a lot of effort to play Chinese rhythms and Chinese harmonies, and it's been very fun for us to sort of dig into this piece. This is, Spring Festival is another name of the Chinese New Year. So imagine a big golden lion with fireworks and a dance, dancers, martial arts dancers, and the song is reminiscent of a song called Lion Plays with Ball. Hard to YouTube to find the original song, because you just get videos of lions and zoos playing with ball. So we are going to give our interpretation of Chen Yi's Spring Festival, and we hope you enjoy this.
Thank you.
Isn't that fun? Can you imagine a middle school band playing it? So there are about 20 pieces in that series, and many of them are very cool, but they're very hard. But it's a really neat series. Next up, we are playing two underdog stories tonight. The first one, The Army of the Nile, is about the British Eighth Army. So if you can imagine World War II, the British Army was in Egypt, and they were protecting the Suez Canal. And Mussolini sent 130,000 troops to take over the Suez Canal, and they were repelled by the British Army of about 30,000. And so we dedicate this, of course, to the people in the Ukraine who are doing the same thing, and they're repelling the massive force of Russia. And so we are playing two underdog stories to hope inspire you and them. And to bring this piece to life, we have invited one of our students to help conduct it. So please welcome our music education senior, Mr. Nick Pirondi, to conduct.
Thank you.
We are also continuing the tradition of featuring one of our student soloists. The rule is basically they have to be in the band, and we held a competition, I think it was in January, and our student Alora Dawson, who you'll hear in just a moment, is... I heard something. She'll be out here in just a moment, and she's going to wow you with a piece almost 200 years old, with the Carl Maria von Weber concertino, that's what it is, concertino. And again, we hope you enjoy this. She's worked really hard. She is off next year for a master's degree at the University of Montana in Missoula, and we're really happy to feature her on this concert. Please welcome Alora Dawson.
Thank you.
Wow, for 9 weeks worth of work, this is going pretty quickly. This concert, again, and our whole year really couldn't have been done just by myself alone, and so I'd just like to take a few seconds and thank a whole lot of people. First of all, Bill and Joe and Kayleen, who are up in the booth that are helping us with all of our technology and lighting and everything. Thank you very much, everybody up there. I'm surrounded by the best faculty known around, and I would just like to thank all of my colleagues and friends for helping us out. For example, Eddie Ludema, he did some brass sectionals, and our last piece features some technology, and we were going to do this hugely complicated thing, and Eddie was going to do all this stuff with a laptop and wires, and we found out we had some synthesizers in the basement, and so we just used the synthesizer. So thank you, Eddie, for doing all that kind of good stuff. We've got lots more. We had talked to John Armstrong about recording some of this, and so he's up here, and he's done wonderful things for the band program. Tom Hasenflug, of course, is eager to come and help with percussion, and when I asked him for Chinese cymbals, he's just like, this one? I said, yeah, yay. Pat Brooks covered for me in February. I had to take a forced one-week vacation, and so he came in and did the band and kept us moving forward through the Omicron wave. And so I'd just like to thank Pat for all the work that he's done and continues to do. He gets his own applause. Yay, Pat Brooks. And of course, it's taken 11 years to get two of my best friends up here on stage. Michael Hellman was up here. There he is over there. And of course, Chandra Hellman over here. They're just happy to come in and assist. And actually, our vocal faculty is involved in this concert as well, as you'll see in just a moment. We have a soprano soloist, and I didn't really know how to do that. So I went to the voice faculty, who are wonderful, and we set up an audition, and you're going to hear the result of that in just a moment. So thank you, voice faculty. You guys are awesome. We have some guests, so we do have some technology, and so we had to find some people to sort of help us out with this round. So I just want to thank our synthesizer section. We've got Emma, Sharon, Kyle, and Sam, who came in and helped us with our synthesizer section, which you're going to love in just a moment, so give them a hand. And of course, our biggest group of people, these people, imagine the life we all lived 4 years ago. They came to college 4 years ago, and it was a different world. We didn't have to deal with pantyhose on our instruments, and masks, and football games, and super spreaders, and all the things that we've been doing. We love the fact that we're here today and able to present music old school, and you can see our faces. But it's been, they've had two and a half of the most difficult years, and that's of course our seniors. So with seniors, would you please stand up? Thank you very much. I'm gonna miss all of them, even Nick. Even Nick. And Sean. I'm gonna miss all of them, okay. and that's it, I hope I didn't forget anybody, but again, this concert and all of our concerts and this whole program is supported by so many people, and I just again, as somebody who was just trying this out for a year, I just want to say thank you to everybody who helped out, because it took a lot of us to get to this point. And we're almost there. So, David. welcome to probably the most interesting piece of music we've played all year. The rule is, when you graduate and go back to your band concert of your alma mater, they're playing cooler music than you ever did. And that was David for me. I was student teaching, I went back to the band concert, I sat in like the fourth row, right in front of the soprano soloist, and I went, oh, that's neat. And it's taken me 25 years to be able to have a group that could actually perform this wonderful piece, and I think you're really going to like it. What is it? I can't really describe it too much. The umbrella idea is the story of David and Goliath. Okay, so we've got this David. You're going to hear a battle far away. By the end, you're going to experience David versus Goliath and all of that. But the middle is something completely different. As it says in your program, there's a tale and there's a story. And I've asked Professor Kathleen Lane to give you the story before we begin. So we'll invite her up in just a moment. And so she's going to give you the story of David and the touchstone. This whole middle section is just a metaphor for things. And it could be however you feel. Stephen Malio's metaphor is about finding something and giving it away, and how we give away ourselves to other people, to causes, to things. This could be a love story, how we find that perfect thing, that perfect human, that puppy dog that you love, or how you've lost that love and you didn't realize how wonderful it was until it was gone. That's in this piece too. Yeah, with synthesizers. And so playing the part of David is Claire Smedley Dye, who we'll bring out in just a moment. She, the soprano, is playing a David. Not the David, a David. Or is it the David? Yeah. I really do hope you enjoy this. We have worked so hard on this piece, and it is magical, and it is wonderful. And so if you would, we're just going to get to it. Please welcome to the stage Professor Kathleen Lane to read the tale. And please welcome to the stage our soprano soloist, Claire Smedley Dye. This is David by Stephen Malio.
Once there was a man who searched for a single stone on the seemingly endless shores of a pebble-laden beach. A young man, he began his search with great faith and hope. With each and every stone, he bent to his knee, clutched his possible prize, and touched it to a simple chain he wore around his neck. When the chain turned to gold, his search would be over, for he would have found the touchstone. Days passed, then weeks, then months, then years, until finally he had reached the end of his life. Old and worn, he looked back over the many miles. Tired and defeated, he looked down at the chain around his neck. It had turned to gold. He had found the touchstone. But caught in the persistence of his actions, he had thrown it away.
Thank you all very much for coming. Have a safe night. Happy Friday.